All the products around us have carbon emissions related to them, their carbon footprints. But how do you calculate these? And this is where things get tricky and time-consuming and even expensive. So is there a shortcut to it? A time saver? A holy grail of carbon emission calculations? Is using AI the solution? Is it easy to use? Can I use the results that I get? And is it even accurate? I will be looking into all of this as I conducted a lot of experiments using AI for calculating carbon footprints, and you would not believe what I found out if I wasn't showing it to you. And I will also share the prompts that I used, the methods that I used, the results that I got, and the questions that still remained. But first, let me shortly explain how carbon footprints are usually calculated and which challenges we usually face. If you're a pro in this field, you can jump to the timestamp indicated below. Products are manufactured using raw materials which have to be extracted somewhere, then transported to a factory, which then is transforming these raw materials into a product which might be transported to the next factory which is doing the next product out of it, and so on. Some products have a lot of steps to it. Then they are transported to a shop or to a warehouse if it is online shopping. Then, once finished and sold, the product is in use, hopefully for a long time span. And during that time, it may also consume energy or resources around it. Then, when the product reaches its end of life, it needs to be transported again, either to landfill or to recycling, or it might be reused in the cycle again, which would be fully circular then. For all these phases, we have emissions attached, emissions for energy use, or for the processes. If we want to calculate a footprint, we first have to decide on the system boundaries. If we want to calculate from cradle to gate, that would be from extracting the raw materials to the factory gates. That would be the first scope we could take into account. Then we could calculate from cradle to grave, which would end the product somewhere in landfill. Or we could go fully circular, cradle to cradle. That would include the recycling and upcycling and reuse possibilities of a product. Once we know what we want to calculate, we need to collect the data. And this is the really tricky part. We might also need to get data from our suppliers, which is very difficult often because sometimes they don't want to pass on the data and sometimes they simply don't have it. And we need data for every step along the value chain of this cycle. Emission factors, for example. And those are not easy to get, they're not openly available. They are stored in private databases and usually we use specialized software to do the calculations. But even so, using this specialized software, we often have the problem that we might not find the exactly right data we are searching for. Or we might just be spoiled by choice and do not know exactly which of the data sets now applies to our product. Now let's assume we have all the data available, then it's quite straightforward to calculate the footprint. But from my experience, there's always something missing and it seems to take ages to get the missing data. And this is the next big challenge that we face, and that is time. If a company has to do footprints for thousands of products, it takes up so much time to prepare those. Would it not be good to have some support to at least estimate the product carbon footprints of the products and then being able to optimize the worst performing ones first? At the Senior Foundation, we were discussing this topic and then out of the blue, someone came up with the idea, well, maybe ChatGPT could do some calculations on that. And we were not sure whether it was really already up to this, but we thought we'd give it a try, and I did some experiments using ChatGPT for that. And the results were highly surprising in a way that I wouldn't have thought of before. But what exactly did I ask ChatGPT to help me with this task? Well, first I started with the simplest questions. Can you help me calculate carbon footprints? And the answer was already quite impressive. I could have used it in this video to explain how to calculate a carbon footprint, which maybe I did. Next, I wanted to calculate actually a carbon footprint, and as I have a lot of experience in the construction industry, I thought I'd go with a concrete mix design so I can follow along and spot any mistakes it's doing. First, I wanted to get an up-to-date recipe for low-carbon concrete, and I was already quite impressed with that. But let's not dive deep into that. We are here for the carbon footprint calculation, so let's go to that now. And this is crazy, I can't believe it. I mean, I did not give too much data, and I told it to use all the data of its own knowledge, and still this is so impressive. It's really absolutely in the range that I was guessing it will be. And yes, there are some minor mistakes here and there. For example, transport is very low, much lower than expected. However, it's anyway not the biggest impact, so, well, probably it doesn't matter. This is in the range I expected the carbon footprint to be. And it even says it's a very rough estimation, but it's helping me exactly in the way that I planned it. And this is, well, I see directly which of the emissions are the highest, the cement, which of course I expected before, but yeah, it helps me optimize. Now, if you want everything to be simple and easy and straightforward, you should stop the video right now, because now I will be diving deeper into the possibilities of ChatGPT and also into the challenges that it faces. ChatGPT was working very well for concrete, but then there's also a lot of publications out there about concrete and about the carbon emissions involved to it, so probably this was an easy task. I also tested other common construction materials, and it was going pretty well. It was impressive. Sometimes the emission factors were slightly off, or sometimes it told me that it doesn't have data available for a certain process. So that would involve getting the data from somewhere else, asking suppliers or anyone. But I was in general pretty impressed. So I moved on to whole construction projects. And this is where things really got interesting and really turned wild. Let me show you this. And I showed it also to several very clever people and asked them to spot the mistake. And none of them did in a decent time. If you're feeling adventurous today, stop the video here and try to figure it out. But please let me know in the comments how long it took you. Now, let's have a look at the calculation method. It seems perfectly right. All the numbers seem more or less right, and the units also seem right, but the result doesn't. It is far too low, and this is where it gets bizarre. I took out my hand calculator and calculated it with the numbers provided by ChatGPT, and calculated it again and again and again till I finally believed. ChatGPT wasn't able to calculate the calculation it put up itself. My own result was about 10 times higher than the ChatGPT result. It was also slightly different, but this could be due to rounding mistakes, so that's off the table for me. But ChatGPT putting up the right calculation method and not being able to calculate it? Really? And it did not only happen once. Once I knew about this issue, I was calculating a lot more by hand, and it happened again and again. And if you know how this could happen, please also let me know in the comments. So would I currently recommend ChatGPT to run carbon footprint calculations? Well, it depends. You certainly need your own calculator, and it's certainly not accurate enough to use it in any product description or any other publication about the product. However, if your goal is to get an overview about your product portfolio and to find out which products are the highest contributors and which you should be tackling first, it might be an option. But only if you have some knowledge about LCA calculations and if you somehow get the feel if something isn't right. Based on the experiments that I made, I think ChatGPT can really be used to make rough estimations and to then continue with the high focus products with the real calculation tools. You need expert software to get it right. If you want to get more insights about carbon emissions and the challenges of data exchange between companies, I would recommend you to watch this video here. I will continue testing in the meanwhile.